Alright guys, so this is Luigi Rocks 2014 bringing you part 11 of Super Mario Odyssey. Today is June 23rd, 2023 that I'm now recording the post commentary on. Hopefully I can try to get most of this game done today if possible. At least the post recording portion, that is. If not, it's like, you know, I can always wait till another week, but, yeah, in this video, we're just gonna continue collecting more, we're gonna try to get the last, fountain thingy and take on the boss for this, kingdom. So yeah, right now, I'm just kinda, like, messing around a bit. Finding more power moons and coins to collect. In this video, I actually do end up collecting quite a lot of power moons. So, that is pretty much what you're going to be mostly seeing in this 26 minute footage. And then, yeah, the boss fight will pretty much be like near the end of the video. So, yep. Just want to grab this little bubble water-like enemy, and oh yeah, there's a 8-bit pipe down there, which we'll be going to soon. Yeah, I think I ended up using this guy to get to one of the power moons. If you remember, I think it was in the last video, there was a power moon and purple coins that you couldn't really get unless I think you have one of these enemies with you. Oh yeah, no, it's not this one. There we go, yep. Yeah, you basically needed one of these little guys to get up there. Which is pretty much what made getting those power moons really difficult. Oh, yep, just land in that so you can replenish your water thingy. Oh, there's a rocket, ooh. Definitely gonna have to check that out soon. If I did check it out in this video, that is. I mean, I don't think I would have been stupid enough to just simply ignore it. Okay, there we go. Yeah, use this guy, and then there you go. That's the power moon, ride the jet stream. Yeah, I think there was one time I've tried getting that power moon so many times, and it just didn't work out so great. Like, without this little, jet stream enemy, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, it's not a jet stream enemy. I just don't really know what these guys are really called, and I don't care to consult the strategy guide. Beach house. Okay, yeah, you don't want to be riding this guy on land for too long. Okay, yeah, we're just gonna get onto this rocket. And make our way to another hidden level thing. Alright. I don't even know if I want to activate that. Oh yeah, you do. If you activate those, that'll clear your pathway, making it easier for you to see where to go. So actually, that does come in handy. It's not really as annoying as one of the other foggy areas we were at, so I guess that's alright. I gotta grab all those coins. Okay. Yep, just try to be a little bit careful here. Don't fall off like I almost did. Head up here, and then there's your power moon. I don't think there's really any other ones in this area. I think it's just that one. Alright. And now we'll just head on back. So yeah, like I said, I do end up collecting a lot of power moons in this area before heading to the boss. Because, you know, I figured why not. Yes, I think what you should do is you should grab the flower before hitting the musical notes, because this is a thing where you really gotta be, like super duper fast, and you can see I already screwed it up. I don't know if I end up cutting this out or not. I think I probably do. Yeah. Yeah, I think... and see, okay. I thought I missed a few there, but no. Yeah, just collect all those musical notes, and then, yeah, you get yourself another power moon. I think it's like, yeah, taking notes, ocean, surface, dash. Alright, so I think the next one is gonna be the next two. I think we're gonna be going into some pipes. Yeah, I'm not collecting all of them, I'm just collecting whichever ones I find and all that stuff. So there's one in above where the pipe is. There's also some purple coins to collect. Yep, just hit those blocks there. It doesn't really do any good because I end up dying anyway, so... yeah. Oh well. Okay, you actually need a Koopa to get over here. With these 8-bit areas, you actually can't really pick up Koopas, so what you gotta do... you have to find another 8-bit pipe to go into. Like maybe this one over here, perhaps? Yeah. Go into this pipe, and I think you can, use this Koopa to break that block. Yep. Once you do that, crouch down here, and you'll find a hidden power moon. Ocean bottom maze hidden room. Yep. So get that power moon. Now we just gotta get the one that's pretty much in plain sight. Of course, I ended up being really stupid here, and I ended up dying, so... this power moon took me a few attempts to get. Alright. So yeah, just head down this pipe over here. Yeah. Yeah, what you actually want to do is you just want to hit the Koopa from within the block itself. You don't really want to actually land on him, because you'll see that a stupid mistake I made here was, yeah, see, by letting the platform over there, he wasn't able to hit the block, and that kind of screwed me over, so... I think the only other option left was to just pretty much restart the thing over, so it was like... yeah, I ended up having to just die and restart over. Yeah, because here I was trying to see if I could just pick the Koopa up, but that didn't really work out so great. Yep. So, yep, I pretty much die and end up having to just restart over. So yep, just grab this thing again. The Dash Tulip is what I'm probably going to call it. It's like the Dash Pepper from Mario Galaxy 2, except the only difference is that you don't actually need Yoshi to get it. Alright, so let's try this again and not do some stupid crap this time. Alright, so hit this. See, that actually works better. Just have the Koopa fall down there, and then you can just do that. Yeah, what I was trying to do here wasn't actually getting the Power Moon, but I was trying to get the purple coins that were over here. Even if I'm not going for 100%, I still want to try to grab as much as I can find and get. Alright, so now Yeah, there's a power moon down there. Which, because I died, I have to reactivate those hidden blocks that are over there. Because, yeah, you can see I can't fall down there normally without it. So, yep, reactivate those blocks and then just go back. I think it was that pipe over there. Not the one on the left, but right where I'm about to jump in. Alright, yep, so head over here, fall down, and then grab some coins, and then grab this power moon, the maze treasure, or just treasure, I guess. And then if you want some more coins, you can just head over here into this pipe. Oh yeah, there's pipe. There's some coins there. I think the rest of the blocks, all you really can do is just destroy them. You can't really do much else. Alright, yep, so grab onto the Cheep Cheep and do a little swimming around. Alright. Yeah, I'm not really sure. I can't really remember what else I end up doing here. I did check this footage a little bit before I started recording this, by the way, in case you're curious. But, yeah, over here I come and grab this, life heart, which doesn't really do me a whole lot of good because I end up losing it eventually. You know, not even going into the boss fight, I couldn't even keep it. Even when I was fighting the boss in this kingdom. Yeah, it was kind of a waste, but yeah. It's yet another reason why I never spend any coins on these, because it's just, to me, it's just not worth it half the times. Like, I just don't feel like it's worth wasting coins trying to get life hearts. Alright, yeah, that's good to know. If I gave a crap, which I don't. Alright, so let's see, head over here. Alright, let's see what's in that cave. I think I was already in there before. So you need this guy to get this power moon here. Yeah, it took me a little while to figure out how I was supposed to get them, but I eventually did. And yeah, I decided to land in here to get more water. Because, yeah, the next power moon, we're going to have to go a little higher. Now, technically, this isn't really how you're supposed to get up here. But yeah, you can technically take a shortcut. I guess you could call that a shortcut, basically. Now, I don't end up activating that switch just yet because I wanted to keep collecting more power moons and more purple coins before moving on. Before moving on to the boss fight, so yeah. Like, see over here, there's some purple coins here that I wanted to get. I think mostly in this video, I think I end up collecting up to 64 purple coins in total for this kingdom. At least for this video. I might end up finding more, but who knows. Yep, so we'll just keep looking around. Yeah, I don't activate that switch just yet. What I was trying to do was find some Goombas so I can... Because if you didn't see, there was that, female Goomba. Yeah, I was trying to get, like, a huge stack of Goombas. I was kind of hoping to find more than just three, but, you know, after doing a little exploring, I kind of realized, okay, there probably isn't any more Goombas around here. So that was when I decided, okay, I'll just try to make do with what I got, and hopefully, you know, I could still get the Power Moon regardless. Because, you know, as they say, three is the magic number. Or should be the magic number, but, you know, we're about to find out here if it still holds up true to this day. Okay, come on. Yep, I guess it's true after all. Three really do be the magic number. Alright. So there you go. Loved by the Seaside. That's another Power Moon collected. Alright. So now we're just gonna make our way over to the next part, next area thing. Let's see here. Yep, just head over here. Oh yeah, purple coins. That's what I was here to get. Oh yeah, and this next Power Moon actually ends up being pretty annoying. Unfortunately, you have to use Cappy to open up the thing to the bottom part of this area. So what this means is you can't bring a Cheep Cheep in here just to be able to collect the moon shards. So yeah, very unfortunate. And yeah, we got these really annoying eels, which I almost ended up losing my life hearts before even having the chance to face the boss in this level, but luckily I was able to recover and, you know, I get the Power Moon before running out. So yeah. Let's see, yep. The last Power Moon is really the most annoying one to find. I went over to the crates here thinking, oh, maybe the last Power Moon shard's in here, but, or at least I think that's what I did. Either that or I actually did mean to find a heart there. Whatever the case, though, it definitely worked out, because, yeah, I definitely needed health. And I don't know if a part of me was going to be able to wait until after I got all the Power Moon shards, especially considering that this last one was sort of a pain in the ass to find, but what was really dumb and stupid is, yeah, I didn't really check up here first before checking down below. So that was a part of what screwed me over, was not checking up here first, so. Well, slightly screwed me over, I should say. So yeah, there you go. Moon shards in the sea. I can't really say that's really my favorite Power Moon, but yeah. Oh yeah, and that's another interesting thing. March 17th was actually St. Patrick's Day that I was recording this, so yeah. It actually makes sense that I... It's actually kind of interesting. It's funny I didn't even notice that in part 13 that I was recording this on St. Patrick's Day in 2021, so... Yeah. Yeah, there are some videos that I have recorded on some holidays. In fact, one game I definitely remember recording on the 4th of July was Luigi's Mansion for the GameCube. I either recorded the first 4 or 8 parts of that walkthrough. I think it was actually 8 parts that I recorded. And of course, that walkthrough you're not going to be seeing for a while. Because I think that was like walkthrough number 43, if I remember correctly. I could check my phone, but I really don't feel like it right now. I'm pretty sure it was walkthrough number 43, because I remembered A Hat in Time. That was my 40th walkthrough. And it was after walkthrough number 40 that I kind of went back into the whole genre of recording more classic games afterwards. Yeah, pretty much from Super Mario 3D World and onwards, yeah, I decided to start doing Nintendo Switch walkthroughs, like a saga of Nintendo Switch walkthroughs, just because I've had people honestly like asking me to record Nintendo Switch walkthroughs, especially actual Nintendo Switch games such as this, and not those Wii U ports like New Super Luigi U or Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze or Captain Toad Treasure Tracker. You know, people wanted actual Nintendo Switch games. And I'd say that this and A Hat in Time pretty much comes as close as that. Now, because I hadn't played this game for like 2 years at the time of recording this, I forgot how to actually beat this boss. Because, remember, it was 2019 that I first beat this game, and 2021 was the year I ended up playing through this the second time. So, yeah, of course, I forgot how to actually beat this guy. You're actually supposed... There was another button you have to press. I think it was like the Y button to shoot the water down below him. Because, yeah, what I was doing is I was just mostly flying above him and not realizing, okay, there was a different button I have to press to land the hit. And it pretty much wasn't actually until I lost all my hearts that I pretty much realized that. Because, yeah, I was being really dumb and stupid at the time of recording this, not realizing what I was supposed to do here. Yeah, I think this would have definitely went a whole lot better if I'd just known pretty much from the get-go what I was supposed to do. Yeah, I thought maybe I could just tackle him head-on like that, but nope. Doesn't really work that way, it seems. And the most stupidest part, I think it was right here coming up. The most stupidest part was I went to go and try to get some hearts before I ran out of my life hearts. And, like, the extra life hearts. And just as I was about to get it, I lost all my hearts. Like, I lost the life heart thing that I got. Like, literally, that was, like, the stupidest way I could have possibly lost it. Like, even looking at this footage now, it irritates me even to this day looking at this, because it's, like, that was a very preventable situation, and yet it still happened, you know? Like, that's one thing that honestly pisses me off about that part, is that, yeah, I definitely could have prevented that, and nope. Yep, could have prevented myself from losing all the extra life hearts that I got, and nope, I couldn't do it. But yeah, I was still being pretty dumb and stupid here and trying to figure out what I was supposed to do, because remember, this was 2 days after I recorded the first 12 parts that I started, because like, I think there was another kingdom before this one that explained how to do this, or no, I think this was the first kingdom you encountered these little water-like enemies that you can ride on, and I don't know. I think if I had opened up the action guide or whatever, I think it would have told me how to actually control this thing, but yeah, I didn't look that up at the time. Yeah, well, this guy's almost dead. We just gotta... literally just have to try to land a few more hits. And yeah, eventually I did figure out how to actually hit him, but like I said, I was being completely dumb and stupid and not realizing what I was supposed to do. And yeah, this guy just kept running off before I even had a chance to even try to hit him. Somehow I was able to get my hearts back. And then... there we go. He's defeated. Yep, the price was pretty high on this one, but, you know, at least we managed to save the Sea Kingdom, I think is what this is called. I'm not sure. Remember, I'm also recording the post recording on a different day, or at least this video on a different day, when it comes to the post-recording, so... Yeah, I kinda had forgotten what this kingdom was called. Maybe it'll display it up here. But yeah, I think it was Sea Kingdom. The glass is half full. Alright, well... Yeah, that pretty much ends up being it for mostly the power moons and the coins and stuff. I think all I end up doing from this point on is just doing a slight bit of exploring around or whatever. Yeah, because I think I realized, okay, I'm probably coming up at the end of the video soon, so I probably should just start a new video. Yep. Yeah, so I think pretty much, yeah, that ends up being the end of the video, so... Yeah, thank you all for watching. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to join the Discord down below. And I'll see you guys next time in Part 16. Until then, this is LuigiRocks2014, signing out. Peace out, guys.